Last section of this chapter 11 is talking about Geographic Information Systems, GIS. What is this Geographic Information Systems? We are going to understand with the help of this last section of chapter 11. So, Geographic Information Systems captures, manages, analyzes, and displays multidimensional geographic data, also called geospatial data. So, it is responsible to capture, manage, analyze, and display data. This data is multidimensional data related to a specific geography. That's why it's being also called as geospatial data. Geospatial data, where things or people are and where they are going right now, what is the situation and what may happen. With descriptive data, what things are like or what customers are doing. So this is GIS. Map shows few details like name of the location and location. It's a flat map. GIS is more than a map. Multiple layers of information for many ways of thinking about a geographic space. Let's see this diagram to understand more. The first layer is talking about the parcels. Parcels means packets of land. Okay. The second layer is zoning. If I'm in a position to see a particular zone, then it is zoning. Packet parceling, huge packet of data, large mass of data, and then zoning within that, how much areas we have, different zones we have, this is zoning. Then topography, level of land and other natural information about the land. Wetlands, where do we have water? Demographics, populated, vegetated, land covered, how the land is being covered. Imagery, now you are in a position to see the buildings, etc. And then base map. So, a lot of descriptive. By moving on the map or the hovering over a state such as Texas, another layer of data about sales and financial data appears. Whenever you are moving or hovering around a particular geographical area, you will be able to know more about that geographical area. So, this is one depiction of Texas. This is something based on global integration. What is this global integration? It's internal data, external data, live data from multiple channels. Global integration. Cellular, internet service providers, sensors, Google Earth, GPS, and RFID systems are in position to put together, work together. Know the location of each connected user or object. Now, if we are in a position to connect to them, then this is global integration. Foursquare, Google Maps, and other mobile apps rely on GPS locations. This GIS can be used as a business application. Business applications may be developed on the basis of GIS. So, it learns how store sales are impacted by population or proximity to competitors' store. Use GIS to identify relevant demographics, proximity to highways, public transportation, and computer stores to select the best location options. In this very chapter when I started, I have shared one map with you and shared this thing with you. Food and consumer products companies can chart locations of complaints, call enabling product traceability in the event of crisis or a recall. Sales representatives might better target their customer visits by analyzing the geography of a sales target. So, in this manner, friends, we are in a position to use something known as Geographic Information Systems. And with the help of this, we have concluded this chapter 11. Thank you very much.